It's Philadelphia's Renaissance Radio Station, WNJC, 1360 AM, Washington Township, Philadelphia. Broadcasting online, WNJC1360.com, a service of Forsyth Broadcasting.
Up next on WNJC is the Kevin Storm Show with Kevin Storm.
Kevin Storm Show. My mom and I were looking for a guest and we couldn't find anyone, so at last minute we just came up with the idea to talk about our upcoming plans and we were supposed to be in Richmond, but for some reason we're not.
It looks like our guest star is going to be Treasure Orlando. Our big tabby cat has decided to sit on Kevin. So, okay, he's so intrusive. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, new on my plate is I now have blue hair.
Well, we don't have any video for today, so you're probably not going to get to see his blue hair. We did take a few minutes before going on today to listen to last week's show. I really hope that anyone that was listening really enjoyed last week's show. We enjoyed doing it, and it was a lot of fun, and it sounds great. I'm really surprised that it sounded that great. It definitely would not if it weren't for Robert Joseph there helping us out.
So, some of the things we did last week were we went to... Well, I created a protest for the Kelly Miller Circus that was at my old elementary school on Thursday.
Yeah, and we were very fortunate to have some friends jump in and take over. And
they brought ponchos, which was convenient considering it started raining.
That was nice.
During the second half.
And someone brought a lot of signs for us to hold and to post up, even though the crowd wasn't that big because of the rain. We stayed out there in the rain, and it was very, very interesting. We got soaking wet, but it was fun. It was nice to be able to talk to a few people, and the signs were beautiful, right?
Yeah, they were pretty cool.
We had a lot of information posted online. Someone actually recorded a video prior to the circus that showed the elephants and the camels tied up. The poor camels were tied to the trailer and RV, like, so tight that they couldn't move, and one of the elephants was swaying really bad. So, like, that video is on the Kevin Storm Show Facebook page, which is facebook.com/abolitioninmedia.
For anyone who's checked out the page recently or saw any new videos, all four kittens are still available for adoption.
Well, that's if they know what you're talking about. Well, some people are listening and they don't have a clue what we're talking about. We had two feral kittens from New York, and one of them had four kittens. So, and they're gorgeous. One has a split face, the different colors on both sides of the face, like the mom. And there's a black and white one that looks like Sylvester, but it's a female, so she's calico. And there's one long-haired tabby, and he's just puffy, fat, and lazy. And yeah. And then there's a gray one with a little bit of white on his belly. That's a boy. So they're definitely available now. They're 6 weeks old. As far as I can tell, they seem to be very healthy.
They're potty trained and eating crunchy food.
Yeah, they eat well. They use the litter box well. They play well. And we're trying to train them not to scratch at certain things, but giving them other things to scratch at. So, but hopefully someone local that is...
I noticed them leaping for the scratching post on the handle of the bathroom door.
Oh, well, that's a nice thing. All right, so what else do we have going? We still have the conference.
Oh, yeah, the panel.
Yeah, in 2 weeks, we're going to be in Washington, D.C. at the Hilton Alexandria for the Animal Rights National Conference. And the website for that is arconference.org. You can check that out, or you can look on our page.
Oh, I should have led with this, but happy Father's Day to all the dads out there celebrating.
That's nice.
And I'm actually going out to dinner for Father's Day with my dad today.
You know where you're going?
Be fun. No, I'm not sure.
Okay.
But we did get him a, Pink Floyd shirt.
Oh, that was nice.
And,
now, if you go to a regular diner, what do you think you're going to eat?
I don't know. We were talking earlier saying that to make my grandma mad.
Oh, no, not to make her mad, but...
To be really specific and order something, like, super healthy, because... That's not what she would expect me to order.
So what do you think you want?
I'd probably get a salad, and then if I still have, if I'm still hungry after I eat that, I might find out if their fries aren't contaminated, like if anything else is baked in the fry grease that I wouldn't be okay with, and if it's not, then I guess I'll get some fries.
Yeah, a lot of places use the fry grease for mozzarella sticks and chicken nuggets and all that, and yeah, I don't think we want fries out of there. Even though it's hot, there's a principle involved. It's not always about nutrition or contamination or anything like that, but it's just about the general principle of not supporting, any animal products. And where are you going? He just gets up. See, yeah, that's the pleasure of being at home. He just jumps up and goes to the refrigerator. Orange juice. Oh, that's lovely. He's drinking out of the jug. Not the typical 12-year-old, but he definitely does some 12-year-old things. Besides the fact that he's walking around now with half his head blue, that's very interesting. The right half in the front and the left half in the back. He could be a checkerboard.
I was just going to say that.
Our checkerboard.
Previously mentioned intrusive cat is sitting on my mom's lap now.
Yeah, he's very comfortable.
He's got a black whisker.
So on your page, we have Vegan School 101 on here. Let's see, we put that up there early this morning for like today's post, and then did comments underneath of it. Yeah, they do. I know. Well, we have Vegan School 101 is Dave Warwick's page. He's done a screenplay that he would like to turn into a movie. I don't know what his progress point is right now, but it's going to be called Inherit the Earth, and it's very interesting. You need to just put in, when you look on his page, you'll be able to read about, like, what it's about, who he is, how he came about. You want to read the top part of this? Can you see
okay. Vegan School 101. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for common good, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessing of liberty to ourselves and prosperity, posterity, do ordain and establish veganism for the United States of America.
That's pretty nice. I know he wrote that, like, years ago. So it's a very good webpage. I'm having a hard time actually seeing the original page, but it's, oh, veganschool101.blogspot.com. Very good page. I'm glad he was able to do everything. He's got quotes on here. Actually, they're the parts of his book in the beginning that were written by Dr. Will Tuttle from the World Peace Diet and Dr. T. Colin Campbell. He wrote in it. And also, let's see, Mary Hoffman. There's a quote from her. And what else? Frank and Mary Hoffman from allcreatures.org. Their website is www.all-creatures.org. Very good website, especially if you're a Christian. It's a Christian Vegetarian Association website. John Robbins wrote in his book. He's the author of Diet for a New America, The Food Revolution. And Robert Cohen wrote in there. What else? He's the author of Milk, the Deadly Poison. That's an interesting thing to look up. If you ever get a chance, www.notmilk.com, N-O-T-M-I-L-K.com. That's a really good website. There's a lot of good information on there, especially about dairy. Okay. Oh, that was cool. Go back to that. It had a little picture of the chick. It says
most vegan-friendly
colleges.
This is a list from 2012.
Contest 2000. Okay. Well, it can still be valid.
Oh, yeah.
And it has a little picture of a chick with a PETA 2 flag.
Large schools, small schools.
Okay. After tens of thousands of students came to check out this year's nominees and vote for their favorites, PETA 2 has selected this year's most vegan-friendly colleges, University of California, San Diego, and Wesleyan University.
Very cool. Congratulations to all nominated schools. They have an all-vegan dining hall. Ooh, vegan chocolate cake on the menu.
Oh, speaking of vegan cake, we were supposed to go to a dinner last night at Via Roma, and I had a playoff game, so we missed the event. But we did win. That was the upside. And
you get to go to the playoffs?
And I wished I would have been able to go because I really wanted some vegan cheesecake and the vegan chicken nugget.
Oh, they don't have the cheesecake yet at Via Roma.
Oh, I thought they did.
No, but I'm going to keep bugging them about the cannolis.
You should.
Yeah, Via Roma, we really want vegan cannolis. Their food is awesome.
They're free advertising.
Yeah, right, free advertising. It was the only time in my life I ever had a stromboli. I've had two now from there, and they're great. I like the one with the artichokes and the sun-dried tomatoes, and I don't even remember what else is in there, but they're really good. We're still looking at the college website here. Northwestern University, they also, with their 2011 winners, and University of California, Santa Cruz. That's pretty cool. That's an interesting website. It is on PETA2.com. That's PETA2.com. And, wow, that's neat. That's it just keeps going on. The 2010 winners were Northwestern University and McMaster University, Canadian division. Let me look at.
About a little bit about the Kevin Storm Show page. Our fan count is now up to 318.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
318 fans. Actually,
and mostly because of our last guest, Gary Francione.
Yeah, that was good.
Because throughout that show, along with 30 seconds afterwards, we got over 50 fans.
Yeah, that was a good day for fanage. Okay, well, yeah, actually, I've gotten quite a few fans for him from work. He has business cards made up with a nice picture of him on and all the information, the websites, and how to contact us. And so I pass them out sometimes just when I'm having a conversation with someone about kids or veganism or, you know, whatever else. Sometimes I deal with kids on the job, meaning, you know, over 18, they're kids to me, up to about 20-something. And, speaking of jobs, I'm going to be starting a new job. And I'm actually not sure who's listening to the show, so maybe I shouldn't have sent any.